bag house that we constructed to make a moderately cool environment for storing all of our seeds and for our seed research. So come inside and have a look how it's built. You can see that we laid up layers of rice bags filled with just ordinary earth from around the building site, and each bag was wired shut, laid down and tamped hard in position, and course after course produced. And so this is where we're storing all our seeds, and we're recording the temperature, and we've found that the temperature is much more constant inside this building than the ambient temperature outside. And it's also an ideal environment for our germination chamber, which needs to be kept at a low 20s kind of temperature so that it can regulate the seed inside at about the optimum 30 degrees Celsius. We found that when we had this in a much warmer office room that was not air conditioned, and tended to heat up during the afternoon, and then it was very hard for the box to then cool down and regulate its temperature. So if you're going to build one of these, you really need a room that stays moderately cool day and night. It's much better. Okay, this is made out of a steel box readily available on the streets of Cambodia. And here we have glued in polystyrene, also available at shops. And we have cut slots in there to accommodate this shelving. Now this shelving is plastic coated wire that's used for displaying in Cambodia, so it's pretty readily available. And at the bottom here we have a 3-watt LED light, and at the top we have a 1-watt LED light, so this is providing plenty of light for all of our trays filling the shelving. And we have a 20-watt fan here. And it's actually the fan that produces most heat in here. So the fan and 3-watt light bulb are controlled by this thermostat here. And the thermostat switches on and off, keeping the temperature at a pretty constant 30 degrees Celsius, as we can see on the thermometer. Now the fan is situated so that it can blow air upwards to the top, and that tends to circulate it around, providing a very constant temperature throughout the cabinet. And also we'll see that we have some water in bottles to provide some thermal mass that stops the thermostat from switching off and on so quickly. And the open water allows humidification of the air in here that stops our trays from drying out too much. And so if we see also out here we have this cheap kind of timer device that's set to give the box 16 hours of light and 8 hours of darkness. And here you can see some of the germ trays in the process of being counted after most of the seeds have been counted out. This is now day 6, and the last couple of seeds are germinating in that tray that started with 50. And that's how we are germinating and checking our seeds.
Did you find that helpful? If you did, consider giving it a like or subscribing to our channel. While you're at it, why not check out our other videos or join our network at ecocommunity.org for more interesting and sustainable agriculture solutions. Network members can receive up to 10 free seed packets.